Commentary, Part 2. Joe Biden's Independence Hall speech in Philadelphia, September 1st, 2022. Joe Biden paints a bleak vision of America, resembling the dystopia that Megadeth warned us about just one album ago. Megadeth has a new album out this week, so I'm celebrating a new Megadeth album. But go back to Dystopia, and it shows this bleak future for America, where we all citizens are monitored, everything is bleak darkness, and those in power jealously control all information and all reality to maintain that power. Does this dystopia foreseen by Megadeth look like Joe Biden's presidency of 2022? Let's examine what Joe Biden says in part 2 of 3 of my commentary examination.
I want to be very clear up front. Not every Republican, not even the majority of Republicans are MAGA Republicans. Not every Republican embraces their extreme ideology. I know, because I've been able to work with these mainstream Republicans. But there's no question that the Republican Party today is dominated, driven, and intimidated by Donald Trump and the MAGA Republicans. And that is a threat to this country.
Now, let's go to what Joe Biden said the day after this speech.
Mr. President, do you consider all Trump supporters to be a threat to the country? No, everyone.
Come on, look, guys. You keep trying to make that case. I don't consider any Trump supporters.
Let's hear that again.
Embraces their extreme ideology. I know, because I've been able to work with these mainstream Republicans. But there's no question that the Republican Party today is dominated, driven, and intimidated by Donald Trump and the MAGA Republicans.
You keep trying to make that case. I don't consider any Trump supporters.
All right, so he says you keep trying to make that case. This is a generic Biden response to Peter Doocy of Fox News. Since Biden was a candidate in 2019. He says that and then says something completely unrelated to what he just said. So he's saying, oh, Peter Doocy, you keep trying to make that case. Well, no, Peter Doocy did not keep trying to make that case. Joe Biden made that case the day before. Is Joe Biden insane? Is he demented? How can he forget what he spoke of for 25 minutes unless he was simply ordered by White House Chief of Staff Ron Klain to simply repeat what was on the teleprompter for 25 minutes on September 1st. Then September 2nd, he can't remember what he said on the previous day.
And that is a threat to this country. These are hard things. I'm an American president.
All right, well, good to know. I'm glad you think you're an American president. Why you'd need to say that out loud, I'm not sure.
President of Red America, Blue America, but of all America. And I believe it's my duty to level with you, to tell the truth, no matter how difficult.
Except about Hunter Biden and his business activities with China and Ukraine.
No matter how painful. And here, my view is what is true. MAGA Republicans do not respect the Constitution.
So, it's September 1st, 2022. MAGA Republicans are not in charge of the Department of Justice, the Federal Bureau of Investigation, the Internal Revenue Service, the Biden White House, the House of Representatives, or the United States Senate, or, for that matter, the U.S. Supreme Court. So, what on earth is Joe Biden talking about? Attempting to parse his words is difficult, but I believe what he's referring to is the string of special election successes by candidates identifying themselves along the lines of being Trump supporters or Trump endorsed. All right, so here's the New York Post, dated September 4th, Story is from August 24th. Trump celebrates all endorsement wins in primary. Great candidates. Former President Donald Trump celebrated all wins from his favorites in primary races on Tuesday evening. Looks like a fantastic evening of all wins. 26-0 tonight, turning numerous tight races into big and easy wins. Overall, for the last 4 years, Donald Trump says he is 98.4% on endorsements.
They do not believe in the rule of law. They do not recognize the will of the people. They refuse to accept the results of a free election.
You mean like Stacey Abrams of Georgia or Hillary Clinton in 2016?
And they're working right now, as I speak, in state after state, to give power to decide elections in America to partisans and cronies. Empowering election deniers.
Not like the bill that the House of Representatives floated, where control of all state elections would be handed over to a federal authority run by the Democratic Party. Oh, you mean, it sounds like Biden is projecting his own failures as president in unifying our country. What about the rule of law says that you raid your predecessor's home hoping to find dirt? That's the rule of law. What about alternatively telling us that the Supreme Court is the settled law of the land, and then telling us that the Supreme Court is rogue and you need to pack the Supreme Court?
Undermine democracy itself. MAGA forces are determined to take this country backwards.
So he's, or whoever wrote his speech, is specifically referring to this. Donald Trump candidates winning across the country. Biden is attacking you for daring to vote against the Democratic Party and against his express wishes. So the enemy of Joe Biden here is not Donald Trump. Joe Biden is saying here that his enemy is the American people. And I want to remind Joe Biden again here, when he's endlessly repeating the evil of MAGA Republicans. Let's go to Wikipedia.org. 2020 United States presidential election. 2020 United States presidential election. Joe Biden, 81 million votes. 13 million more than Barack Obama got, the most popular man alive. Donald Trump, Republican, 74 million votes. So every time Joe Biden says in this speech, MAGA Republicans are the enemy, he's telling you that 74 million Americans who did not vote for Joe Biden but voted against Joe Biden in the 2020 presidential election are, in Joe Biden's mind, his personal enemies and the enemies of democracy. That's a very strange statement to say. Whatever your opinion of Donald Trump, Donald Trump never gave a speech like that, ever, saying that anyone was his enemy. Donald Trump worked for all Americans.
Backwards to an America where there is no right to choose, no right to privacy, no right to contraception, no right to marry who you love.
Actually, none of that's true, but the fact that Biden is worried about the right to privacy, maybe he should talk to his own Attorney General of the United States, Merrick Garland, about that. This is a guy who has done nothing but go after the president's political opponents and people like parents of school children.
They promote authoritarian leaders and they fan the flames of political violence that are a threat to our personal rights.
Fan the flames of political violence. Let's go back here to Trump candidates winning. Where was any violence accompanying any of these wins of these Trump-endorsed candidates? How much violence did Matt Gaetz personally dish out? This guy here in Oklahoma, what was the violence that he started? So I don't know if Biden can actually point to any factual examples of violence by Trump supporters.
To the pursuit of justice, to the rule of law, to the very soul.
So the pursuit of justice is going out after every single official that worked for Donald Trump in the previous 4 years before Biden's administration. A lot of people hoped including myself, that Joe Biden would deliver on his promise to work to unify our nation. Look at this angry man clenching his fists and denouncing the will of the people, denouncing voters voting against Joe Biden. And Joe Biden's angry about that, and he's animated about that. He's going to try to milk the January 6, 2021 insurrection in the hopes that this will cause Republicans not to turn out to vote and that this will cause Democrats to turn out to vote. The problem is we have a very clear example here where Democrat protesters who storm government buildings are not punished in any way. Here's Amy Schumer flouting the law, blocking the operations of the federal government by blocking the confirmation of Judge Brett Kavanaugh to the Supreme Court, disrespecting the authority of the Capitol Police as she and her friends storm the Senate building and stop the Senate proceedings. They had to shut down the Senate and clear the Senate chamber during the Brett Kavanaugh hearings because of this person. Is she in prison? Did she get a 5-year prison sentence? No, she's out on a comedy tour right now that's apparently doing very well. When you are a Democrat protester occupying government buildings, you're a hero. When you're a crazy guy running around protesting everything under the sun, clearly mentally unbalanced, but still, he didn't shoot anybody. There were no shots fired on January 6, 2021 by a single person protesting the certification of the election for Joe Biden. This guy got a 5-year prison sentence. What's the difference? He's not the cousin of Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer. That's the difference. Yeah, here it is right here. Donald Trump on January 6, 2021, at the 18-minute, 16-second mark. I know that everyone here will soon be marching over to the Capitol building to peacefully and patriotically make your voices heard.
Brutally attacking law enforcement, not as insurrectionists,
Now, obviously, I'll show it again. This crowd, an estimated 100,000 to 250,000 peaceful attendees of the Save America rally, did not attack any law enforcement. Joe Biden is attempting to smear this massive crowd of peaceful, patriotic Americans with the 50 miscreants who entered the Senate building before Donald Trump even finished speaking. Obviously, this crowd did not do that, but in Joe Biden's mind, that's what happened, and you cannot correct him on that, ever.
The dagger at the throat of our democracy, but they look at them as patriots, and they see their MAGA failure to stop a peaceful transfer of power after the 2020 election.
So if they're the villains, why was unarmed protester Ashley Babbitt, Air Force veteran, shot in the throat? What dagger did she clutch at the heart of democracy, Mr. Biden?
Election as preparation for the 2022 and 2024 elections.
So that's a nice conflation there. Joe Biden takes 50 people in the Senate building and conflates that with Trump-aligned candidates winning.
They tried everything last time to nullify the votes of 81 million people.
Well, just like you're trying to nullify the votes of 74 million people. Why is it that you only work for the 81 million people that voted for you, Joe? Don't you also work for the people that didn't even show up to vote, let alone the Republican voters?
This time, they're determined to succeed in thwarting the will of the people.
So, he already said that, so... Often in Democrat speeches, you'll see Joe Biden told to simply repeat the same thing over and over. It's a challenge for me to come up with new ways to criticize some of this. He's just saying MAGA bad, MAGA bad, MAGA bad for 25 minutes.
That's why respected conservatives like Federal Circuit Court Judge Michael Ludwig has called Trump and the extreme MAGA Republicans, quote, a clear and present danger to our democracy.
I don't consider any Trump threat.
While the threat to American democracy is real, I want to say as clearly as we can. We are not powerless in the face of these threats. We are not bystanders in this ongoing attack on democracy.
I don't consider any Trump support.
What threat to democracy is there, Mr. Biden? He doesn't say.
There are far more Americans from every background of...
Where's the applause lines where you would pause dramatically and the crowd of 10,000 or 20,000 rabid Biden admirers should be screaming and clapping and interrupting him? They should be making Biden interrupt his speech so often that it goes from 25 minutes to an hour and 10 minutes.
Belief to reject the extreme MAGA ideology than those that accept it.
Mr. Biden, what is the extreme MAGA ideology? Making America great again means simply focusing on American taxpayers, American families, and bringing jobs back to American factories.
And folks.
Oh, there we go. Finally, the applause line.
It's within our power. It's in our hands, yours and mine, to stop the assault on American democracy.
He just said that 30 seconds ago.
I believe America is at an inflection point. One of those moments that determine the shape of everything that's to come after.
You're wrong not to vote for my candidates.
Now, America must choose to move forward or to move backwards.
They're going to move backwards to 4 years ago, sir.
About the past, to be a nation of hope and unity and optimism.
Where is the hope, unity, and optimism coming from you? You have clenched fists railing against voters going against your choices.
We're a nation of fear, division, and of darkness.
And Biden made allusions to fear, division, and darkness in his speech where he accepted the Democratic Party's nomination in 2020. And he repeated this theme in his inaugural address. But he also said he was going to be the man who unified our country.
MAGA Republicans have made their choice. They embrace anger. They thrive on chaos.
This sounds like everything Biden is describing about his administration.
They live not in the light of truth, but in the shadow of lies.
And this is something Biden, if you watch his speeches against Vladimir Putin, he doesn't seem to realize it, but when he's speaking of the battle between light and dark, and he took that rhetoric which he used against Donald Trump and applied it to Vladimir Putin. So if you watch any of his speeches on the conduct of Vladimir Putin before and after Russia's invasion of Ukraine, he uses identical imagery of lightness and darkness for Putin as he did his predecessor. Does that sound like a reasonable thing to say for a man who's supposed to be the moderate unifier who brings our nation together?
Together we can choose a different path. We can choose a better path.
What have you done in the last 17 months to bring our country together?
Forward to the future. A future of possibility, a future to build and dream and hope.
Well, we actually can't build because you canceled the Keystone Pipeline. And I remember watching you in the second presidential debate with Donald Trump promising to cancel the gas and petroleum industries.
Would he close down the oil industry?
It falls.
Would you close down the oil industry?
By the way, I would transition from the oil industry, yes.
Oh,
I would transition. It is a big statement.
That's a
because I would stop.
Why would you do that?
Because the oil industry pollutes significantly.
I see.
Here's the deal. But
that's a big statement.
Well, if you let me finish the statement, because it has to be replaced by renewable energy over time. Over time. And I'd stop giving to the oil industry, I'd stop giving them federal subsidies. He won't give federal subsidies to the gas, to solar and wind.
Yeah.
Why are we giving it to oil industry?
We actually do give it to solar and wind.
We
and
have
that's
one
maybe
final
the biggest
question.
Statement in terms of business. That's the biggest statement.
Okay.
Because basically what he's saying
question,
is he is
Mr.
going
President?
To destroy the oil industry. Okay. Will you remember that, Texas? Will you remember that, Pennsylvania, Oklahoma?
Vice President Biden.
You promised to cancel our fossil fuel industries and force us over to green energy no matter what the cost. You also promised that the Green New Deal was not your plan in that debate, which was a complete lie. The bill that you passed, that every news outlet is boasting as a legislative accomplishment, is the Green New Deal.
And we're on that path moving ahead. I know this nation. I know you, the American people. I know your courage. I know your hearts. And I know our history. This is a nation that honors our Constitution. We do not reject it.
You mean like when the Supreme Court, which is the settled law of the land, decided that abortion was nowhere in the Constitution and was something better handled by the states?
This is a nation that believes in the rule of law. We do not repudiate it.
Again, here's Democratic Party activists blocking and occupying government buildings, the Senate building, forcing the Senate to empty their hearings on Brett Kavanaugh. That's not the rule of law. Why is one form of protest by the Democratic Party acceptable, with no criminal penalties of any sort whatsoever, and yet you throw the book at these other characters? What's the difference?
This is a nation that respects free and fair elections. We honor the will of the people. We do.
All right, so when Democrats say the 2016 election was rigged, and they rioted, what was the difference then? Here we go. This is November 10th, 2016. Democrats burning, looting, rioting, smashing. Lawless, against the law Democrats. Angry, full of rage. Shattering everything they can. Burning. Apparently, some forms of against the law protests are okay for the Democratic Party. So the idea here is the Democratic Party has an exclusive monopoly on anything like this. And if any group that is not aligned with the Democratic Party goes out and riots and burns and smashes things, then that's wrong.
We do not deny it. And this is a nation that rejects violence as a political tool.
Oh, you mean like the riots all through 2020, where Democrat mayors and governors ordered their police departments and fire departments to stand down as George Floyd protesters looted and burned their way across the country.
And respect for others. Patriotism, liberty, justice for all, hope, possibilities. We are still, at our core, a democracy.
I don't know what he's shouting about, but who disagrees with the sentiments of the founding of our country?
And yet, history tells us.
How do all these news networks know that Biden's going to address the soul of the nation?
The blind loyalty to a single leader and the willingness to engage in political violence.
Well, again, we're going to go back to this headline. Joe Biden cannot cite any of these Trump-endorsed candidates who have a willingness to endorse violence.
It's fatal to democracy. For a long time, we told ourselves that American democracy is guaranteed. When it's not, we have to defend it, protect it, stand up for it.
Don't vote against me.
Every one of us.
You're against democracy if you vote against Joe Biden.
I'm asking our nation to come together. Unite behind the single purpose.
They have united behind a single purpose, which is to block the entire Biden domestic and international agenda.
Defending our democracy regardless of your ideologies.
Well, there actually is an American ideology. It's called American exceptionalism, and it's based on the belief that just like every other country in the world, Americans should work to ensure the prosperity and safety of the United States of America. Your administration doesn't seem to work for America or Americans. Why is that, sir?
We're all called by duty and conscience to confront extremists who put their own pursuit of power above all else.
Again, they're projecting. Biden's entire White House staff respects nothing but power.
Democrats, independents,
independents, mainstream Republicans. We must be stronger, more determined, and more committed to saving American democracy.
Biden's attitude is crass political calculation. He believes that as long as he can maintain a razor-thin margin over the American electorate, that he doesn't need those 74 million votes of MAGA Republicans. So, they are the villains of his story.
The MAGA Republicans are to destroying American democracy.
Where are your examples, sir?
We, the people, will not let anyone or anything tear us apart.
We, the people, will not let anyone. Maybe a psychologist can parse that, but, you know, Independence Hall, Philadelphia, where you're standing, sir, you know, e pluribus unum. The idea that there is only unity if it's on your precise terms, that's not unity. That's not a consensus, sir.
Today, there are dangers around us. We cannot allow to prevail.
Why doesn't he see a danger with fentanyl killing record numbers of American youth? Why doesn't he see a danger of not securing our border? Why doesn't he see a danger of China profiting as we engage in a useless war in Ukraine? Joe Biden is ensuring that this century is China's century at the cost of American jobs, security, and prosperity. Why is Biden actively taking steps to eliminate America as a superpower?
We hear you've heard it. More and more talk about violence as an acceptable political...
But we have actual, factual examples of Democrat violence used as a political tool. The riots in the name of justice, sanctioned by the Democratic Party, caused billions of dollars of damage and loss from vandalism, outright theft, arson, looting, and violence against innocent people. And the response of the Democratic Party was to reward the lawbreakers.
In this country, it's not. It can never be an acceptable tool.
Except when it gave the Democratic Party full control over our national agenda in the 2020 presidential election.
It is plain and simple. There is no place for political violence in America, period. None, ever.
Except when it gets Democrats elected. Because it's always mostly peaceful protests when you burn entire towns in the name of Democrat justice.
We saw law enforcement brutally attacked on January 6th.
Brutal assaults on law enforcement sanctioned by the Democratic Party. That's okay, because Joe didn't see that or wasn't shown that by his staff.
We've seen election officials, poll workers, many of them volunteers of both parties, subject to intimidation and death threats.
Well, you wouldn't want to intimidate people to count ballots that all have the same signature. Here we are. Election monitors not permitted to watch vote counting in Detroit because of quote-unquote COVID restrictions. Oh, darn it. COVID restrictions means you can't allow anyone to watch the votes being counted in Detroit. Would this count as intimidation of poll workers and poll monitors, Mr. Biden? It happened.
Can you believe it? FBI agents just doing their job as...
FBI agents working directly for Joe Biden raiding his predecessor's home. FBI agent Lisa Page, Trump's not ever going to become president, right? She wrote to Strzok. No, he won't. We'll stop it. Senior FBI agent Peter Strzok responded. Is this what Joe Biden's referring to?
Directed facing threats to their own lives from their own fellow citizens. On top of that, there are public figures today, yesterday, and the day before predicting and all but calling for mass violence and rioting in the streets. This is inflammatory.
Mr. Biden, your own party called for precisely that to to protest the U.S. Supreme Court at their very homes. This is what the Democratic Party ordered. The Biden White House itself sent the addresses of Supreme Court justices to Democratic Party activist groups to protest on their front lawns and on their streets. This is the lawlessness and intimidation of the U.S. Supreme Court to rule a certain way based on what the Democratic Party wanted them to rule. Why is this considered acceptable, to go to someone's home and threaten them and their families? Yet that is precisely what Joe Biden's White House ordered these Democrat protesters to do.